boys and girls.
Art 101 with Mr. Burger.
Hello friends, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and welcome to this next episode of Art 101 with me, Mr. Burger. As always, remember that the content is geared toward individuals 13 years of age and older, and we're going to begin with somebody that is really fitting for the holiday season, the great rapper of art, Christo. Christo is recognized as the great rapper in the art world, and not like rapper like... but more of a rapper like Packages. Now, where does this story begin? His father was a scientist and his mother was a secretary at the Academy of Fine Arts in Bulgaria. And this is exactly where he would begin his academic studies, traveling to Prague, Czechoslovakia, and then Vienna's Academy of Fine Arts before settling down in Paris, France. He frequented the museums and loved the artwork of Jackson Pollock, Jean Tingley, and Jean Dubuffet.
Sometimes you have to slap them in the face just to get their attention.
After escaping communist rule, he was no longer a citizen and became a man without a country. Later, he would drop his last name and only use his first name, Christo. It was also in Paris where he began rapping.
I started to work with the little cans, tin cans of paint, industrial paint. From the cans to a smaller size, I moved to the small size barrels, and all that trajectory is in the early years, late 50, early years and 60, temporary installation with the exhibition in Cologne in 1961, and at the same time proposal to do the Iron Curtain when Berlin Wall was built.
Beautiful.
Before we get too far, it is fair to say that Christo works parallel with his wife, Jean-Claude. The work of Christo would certainly be changed when he met Jean-Claude in 1958. One of the interesting things about the relationship of Jean-Claude and Christo is that they were both born on June 13th, 1935.
Happy birthday!
At any rate, the two met while Christo was working on a commissioned painting by her mother. Jean-Claude was engaged, and Christo was very interested in meeting up with her stepsister. Now, Jean-Claude goes ahead, gets married, and becomes pregnant by Christo.
I don't think it's appropriate.
It's not about you, douchebag.
After the honeymoon, she leaves her husband for Christo, and they would become married on November the 28th, 1962, and would soon move to New York in 1964.
We never emigrated to the United States. Never. We emigrated to New York City.
Although kind of a silly statement, artists are drawn to the artistic capital of the world, which is New York City. Prior to New York City, it was Paris, France. And prior to that, it was Berlin, Germany. After the outbreak of World War I, it would move to Paris. After World War II, it would move to New York City, the unofficial international capital of art.
Probably New York is the only city in the world when you can speak in any broken language and everything is going ahead. That is the principal reason that we feel very comfortable.
Jean-Claude passed away in November of 2009 as a result of complications due to a ruptured brain aneurysm at the age of 74. Their work began to focus on environments in 1968. They did several projects that include wrappings of trees, interior spaces, monuments, coastal stretches, the Museum of Contemporary Art in Chicago, and even islands.
It looks like a pink nightmare. Are you happy wearing that?
All our projects, they're temporary works of art. They stay for a short time. After 2 weeks, all the materials is removed and industrially recycled for their uses. They're very good materials, steel, pole, cables, all our materials. And when the project is removed, we collect all the original drawings of the engineers, their paper, their all kind of diagrams, and each of our projects have her own documentation exhibition.
They often get harassed by environmentalists who think that they are destroying nature. Although there are probably some really confused deer and birds, and the artists go to great lengths to leave the world as they found it, if not make it better. Going back to surrounded islands near Miami, they removed over 40 tons of garbage from these 11 islands before they worked on the project so that it was a safe environment for the workers and it improved the habitat.
Oh well, then that's okay.
Perhaps the best known of these types of projects is the 2 million plus square foot fabric fence called Running Fence. This work is not about wrapping things at all, and quite frankly, a lot of their work doesn't. Shortly after coming to the United States, Christo and Jean-Claude began to plan for Running Fence, a project that would take about 4 years to get completed. This is a work that ran from the countryside to the ocean in California.
I just don't understand it.
The fence is not the work of art. The work of art is all togetherness, meaning that 2,000 panels is not work of art. They are designed to go through this very, some way ordinary landscape, but suddenly energized by underlying invisible topography of the land.
I didn't know anything, I never did know anything, but now I know that I don't know all of the Christmas morning.
Which is basically to say that the wind, the hills, the tarps, and everything else combined makes the art, not any one single element.
Marcus, get this kid off me before he pisses on me, all right?
In the 1990s, the couple have created several very large projects. One of the most noteworthy is The Gates, that was created in Central Park, New York. It would take these artists 13 years to plan, create, and set up those 7,503 saffron gates that covered 23 miles of path in Central Park.
You know, what do I know? I color for a living, but that, my friends, is determination.
I got to see that everyone got exactly what they wanted for Christmas. Huh?
Christo and Jean-Claude paid an estimated $21 million to see this project realized.
There will be never gates anywhere in the world. This is only gates in Central Park.
They refuse to work with sponsors. They do not take money from taxpayers. And they even pay to rent the public spaces that they use.
We give $3 million check rent to New York City to own the Central Park for 2.5 months. You know, all our projects, they're season projects. They're designed for particular season of the year. The Gates project was particularly designed for winter because we like to have a leafless tree. To the leafless tree, you can see the Central Park, you can see the other gates, especially you can see the buildings around the Central Park. During the summertime, Central Park is like a forest. You cannot see far away the gates. The same thing with surrounded island, the Pink Islands of Florida, was the spring project before the hurricane in Miami came in late in the summer and autumn. And of course, the over the river is the summer project because we like to have the rafters. The rafting season is between June to the end of August. You know, this is how this project, they design it. They design it when that space is used and aesthetically more beneficial for us.
A lucky duck!
Although he started off with very humble beginnings, Christo has used the sale of his drawings to create the income to be able to pay for these very large projects.
Hey, I'm creating scarcity. Drives the prices up.
A lot of people might question his process and how he makes these works happen.
Their artworks generally begin with a sketching and idea development process, finding interesting locations to create the works or a specific location where they want to produce a work. From there, there's a process of getting permits, supplies, models, and other desired documentation to create the project. Once they have the green light to go forward, they have to hire a large crew and staff of individuals to help pull off the project. Typically, the projects are up for about 2 weeks, and then the crew comes back to take it all down before the materials are recycled or sold back to their suppliers. And there's a constant process of selling drawings to generate income. However, it also does not hurt that in the 1970s, it was discovered that Christo was the direct descendant of Friedrich Fischer, a German inventor who developed an advanced ball bearing design. And almost overnight, Krista became a multimillionaire.
Clark, that's the gift that keeps on giving the whole year.
But he and his wife choose to live modestly. They choose to put their income to work in the form of investments and charitable contributions.
I must stop this whole thing.
Like any great team, they each have a role to play in the process. Christo is the primary designer and artist, and Jean-Claude works on the public relations and planning of the works. Christo still lives and works in Manhattan, New York.
A lot of people need me on Christmas, you know? It's a tough holiday.
Oh man, that's a great story. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, my friends.
Merry Christmas! Dinner was full!
Where do you think you're going? Nobody's leaving. Nobody's walking out on this fun old-fashioned family Christmas.
Ho, ho.